Hello, everybody. It's David here with Shadow Six Creations, and we are finally putting together the B25. So let's get a couple things out of the way. It's been an interesting day. I just got back from the ER a little while ago for a really nasty, for some problems with my ear. So I'm excited. Let's have some fun today. So I'm going to grab some gloves, but we're going to get started. So I was finally able to get my airbrush rebuilt. I got the thing that came in for today. And if you hear some weird noise in the background, I'm sorry, we're getting 40 mile an hour winds down here. So yeah, guys, we're ready to go. So there's a couple things we're going to do first. First things first, we're going to get this put together so we can spray. Very excited. So we've obviously got the wings, fuselage, the tail, and the engines. Now, since it's been a minute since I've actually done anything, really done anything with this over the past few weeks, let's kind of take a look and see what we're looking at here. So the glass, where we can help it, we're doing that last. I like to do the glass last because it'll give me a chance to respray anything I need to. That way I'm not risking hitting the glass with any color, because that can be kind of a pain to clean off sometimes. So everything else, we're just holding on for a minute. So we're getting the wings put on. Okay, so we've got the wings, the tail. We'll get the rest of the small stuff. Probably gonna go ahead and do the landing gear so we can actually have this stand. Yeah, I'm excited. Let's go ahead and get this bad boy put together. This is gonna be great. Now, where did I put? Okay, here we go. So now, unfortunately, with all the spraying that I've done, I've sprayed over on the mating surfaces. So cover your ears if you don't like the sound. So what I'm essentially doing is just giving some bare plastic for a mating surface. Otherwise, the glue is not going to stick very well. Now that I'm finally feeling a little bit better and more coherent, I can pay more attention to this. So let's go ahead and get this right. And now I'm just using the flat side. I'm using the actual blade, but I'm keeping it completely flat. And again, be careful with the blade. You cut your fingers off, cut your hand off, cut your arm off. It's not my fault. I warned you. Okay. So, got the mating section for the wings pretty good. Now, it's going to be a little bit more difficult with this. So, this is probably going to take a little bit to do, but I'm trying to think what else we can do to make that transition a little bit better. Ah, there we go. Now, it's also going to be supported by these posts as well on either side. So it'll make things a little bit easier for us. So I'm not going to do a whole lot. I'm just doing enough to be able to get us a mating surface to have the wings full go on to. Now, once we do get the wings and everything else on, we are going to do a final spray. We're going to do a final color, one final layer of the actual paint scheme and everything for the body. And then that'll be good to go. And we can focus on getting everything else going. And we can focus on decals, getting the glass on. And like I said, I'm not doing the glass now because I don't want to ruin the glass when it comes time to put everything on, because I want to have good. You don't want to spray your glass. You don't want paint on it. You don't want the clear coat on it. Nothing like that, because it will ruin your glass. Okay. Now, this is where it's going to get a little tricky. So there's a couple ways that we can do this. One, we can have it kind of set out like that with a nice flat surface, or in this case, since this part is more flat, And where the wings are going to be, I can set it upside down on its belly, and then we can glue it together that way. So let's kind of look and see how we're going to do this. We also need to get that section's clean. And we also need where the wing, where the tail is going to go on. Why in the goodness that wind is nasty today. We've got a storm coming in. So that's supposed to rain, snow, cats and dogs, whatever you want to call it. Okay, so there's our tail. Tail, it's quite simply going to go like that. It's going to be quick and easy. And you know, you can also use the tail like that. So let me move this camera around so I can kind of show you. So it makes a good stable platform for the wings as well. So that's probably the way I'm going to do it. So what I'm probably going to do first is get the tail glued in place. So now that I've shown that, let's get this camera back into position. Okay. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. We're going to do it this way first. So I'm going to put some glue along these mating surfaces. Now, I am using the Citadel plastic glue again because it chemically melts the plastic together. It's not going to work on resin. So if you do like a 3D printed model or anything like that, this does not work on it because this is for your normal plastics. Okay. So let's go ahead and get a good solid bead. Not too much, not too little. All right. And then there are some components in here that I'll have to repaint, respray, whatever the case may be. That's okay. We'll get that fixed and taken care of. So unfortunately, there's a little bit of a gap right there, but I have a way I'm going to fix that. So let's go ahead and flip this over the way she's on her back. Okay, I've got a stuffed tape in here to avoid spraying the Bombay. Okay, it's going to be one of the big things. Now, as I always warn you, you need to dry fit. Especially this. This is going to be very important. So that is going to sit pretty well. But unfortunately, our tail has popped off, so we'll have to go about a different way of doing this, and that's perfectly fine. Because I don't want this tail giving me any issues while it's drying. Oh, I just realized I've got to clean off one section of the tail so I have a good solid mating surface. Okay, just one second here and I'll get back in frame. Okay, let's go ahead and wipe off that glue. There we go. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and reapply some glue. There we go. Okay, now we can do this properly. I wasn't thinking when I did that, so now we're just going to firmly press it down, but not too much. So we're going to have to just let it glue, let it dry like this. So what I'll probably do is we'll see if we can't put that under it. Because I want to give this a good, we want these to dry evenly so we can make sure that the wings are not going to, oh, well, that's not going to work. Because I don't want the wings to be lopsided and looking terrible when we put it together. So let's go ahead and do a dry fit. I've got both the wings. And they just simply slide into the posts. One at a time, apparently, because it doesn't want to cooperate. Okay, there's one. And two for a dry fitting. Okay. So this side might be a little bit tricky. We'll make it work. Alright, now comes the moment of truth. So first thing we're going to do, because of these posts, since these posts give it some support, We definitely need to clean those off. Now, I did say in my last video on updates that we were going to do a longer video, but because of how big these wings are and how big some of these components are, I want these to dry overnight. And so what I'm going to do is we're going to do kind of a two-part video. We'll do part one, I'll post it. In part two, I'll post the rest of it to be able to show everybody where we're at. Okay? So there's definitely a gap on this side, which means, man, it's not going to be too terrible. So I'll show you what I'm talking about. So right there at the wing joint, it's not too bad on that side, but on this side, it's definitely a bit bigger. But there's a couple of ways we can do that. We can hide it with paint. Which I've done before, or I could put on just like a regular thin layer of like a contour putty, which I don't like to do necessarily just because of how finicky it can be. Or we can just leave it alone. So I'm going to try and maneuver this wing just a little bit. And that looks like it's because of the plastic itself. Okay, well, can't get a perfect model every time, but that's okay. All right, so there's a good dry fitting. Okay, here's our dry fit. Say hi to Bob. He's just hanging around. So we'll figure out a way. Let's get these together, and then we will figure out a plan for the rest of this. All right. Here it comes, the moment of truth. So I'm going to get a good bit of glue down so it has as much of a surface area to dry as possible. Good solid. All right. As a matter of fact, we're going to put a little bit up here as well. Okay, there's one side. Golden, good to go. I want to make sure that, yep, that glue is right where we want it. Okay, beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Okay, let's have you just stay right there, my dear. Let's go ahead and get our other side. I'm putting the glue on out of frame so I can see what I'm doing. There's our second side. Now, I'm going to hold on and push onto this just a little bit so the glue actually has a chance to adhere to where we need it. Okay, so that looks really, really good. So I'm going to push down on the tail. Okay. Shall we show it off? Let's take a look. Yeah, beautiful. It's coming together really good. That gap, I've got some ideas for it, so I'm not going to worry too much. There's a gap right there in the tail as well, but again, I have some good ideas. So, there we go. Oh, there we go. Now, we've got the engines. So what I should have done beforehand was clean off some of the mating surface of that area. But that's okay. Let me go ahead. There's a couple of spots where I can apply the glue that will actually keep it on there. that. I'll do this one. Now, these engines are meant to, they are meant to move. And because I had to go ahead and spray the engine itself, I had to put another layer on. Some of the props are different color. So we're not going to add that quite yet. So we're not going to do anything there. Because I also have to spray the bottom side of those. Now, here's where it's going to get fun. We're going to flip her over. And we're going to do the belly. We're going to spray the wings. And we're going to add just a little bit to the tail. So let's see how she holds up for the moment. Okay, beautiful. Now, if you want to do something, if you want to add a little bit of support to the wings, there's not a problem with that. I've got a couple of little toy trucks here that I'm going to use to support the wings. Okay, now she is being supported by the tail a little bit. Now, if you're worried about that, you can lift it up, or we can just go ahead and handle it by hand. So, this is what we're going to do first. So, basically, we've got to do the tail, we've got to do the belly. I've got to respray part of this area. But the nice thing is, or the one thing I'm going to do is I'm not going to mark it off with tape, because these aircraft weren't, the underbelly camouflage was just painted on or air sprayed on. There was no taping anything off. I mean, good grief, you think about the size of this aircraft, there's no way that they're going to do that. So, that being said, let's go ahead and start with the belly. So all I'm going to use is this primer. It's a Vallejo primer. I've used this quite a bit. That's what I'm going to designate for the color of this, of the belly of this aircraft. So let's get some sprayed in there. I'm going to quickly do a test spray. Okay, I just need to adjust a couple things here real quick. All right. Now we're in business. Okay, here we go. Now, I will say when you're using an airbrush, you need to be careful because the tip can build up droplets, and when you go and spray, it will actually give splatter marks to your model. So what I suggest when you are getting ready to do another coat, or when you're getting ready to spray, point it away and then let it spray that way. Now what I'm doing first is I'm doing an outline. I'm doing an outline of where I want the body to have the gray camouflage pattern. So I went a little high. That's okay. I'm going to fix that. It's not going to be a big deal. Okay. Now so everybody can see, let me adjust you. Give me just 1 second here. Perfect. Okay. Now, if you go too high, you're doing too much, don't worry about it. We're also going to work on putting another coat of olive drab on this. Oh, see, that's what I mean right there. So that's why you got to be careful with your airbrush, because it can build up too much paint at the very tip, and that's exactly what it does. Okay, now I'm going to adjust my needle a little bit so we can have a little bit more coming out. Okay, that's a little too much. So we're just going to adjust the needle to be a little bit more narrow. There we go, that's better. Okay, turn her a little bit so everybody can see. Now, if you want light and dark spots, that's perfectly fine. If you really think about it, this aircraft's going to be doing a lot of missions. Paint is going to be peeling from over time, from rocks that may kick up, from just any numerous things could possibly cause the paint to be damaged. So you don't need to worry about one level coat if you want to add a little bit of an effect to it. Okay, so I'm going to focus on this side just a little bit more. Okay, so that belly is not looking too bad so far. Let's pick her up and switch her around just very carefully while that glue is drying. Ooh, yep, that's why we got to be careful. Okay. All right, let's gently. Okay. Now, before I go any further, I want to say if you've made mistakes, remember this. If you're doing airbrushing, now let me go back with that. I'm in no way, shape, or form an expert when it comes to airbrushing, but you can use it to hide mistakes that you found on the model. Okay, keep that in mind. All right, now we're getting there. Okay, let's go ahead and do the wing. And because I want a little bit more paint coming out, there we go. Okay. Now I'm going to go down to a finer point of paint coming out of the nozzle when I do here and here. Now, if you are air spraying or if you're just getting into it, just be careful you don't want to overspray because it's going to pool and then you're going to lose your detail of the model. Okay? Big thing right there. Okay, now that I've got that. Much better. Now keep in mind, I am going to be respraying that olive drab. So right now what I'm focusing on is getting the underbelly coat done. I think we're going to need to go down a little bit finer. And I believe I'm actually going to take this nozzle. Take that one off. Let me see if I have one of my... I do. There we go. Perfect. Okay. Ooh, I'm gonna put a different tip on. It's gonna help focus it down a little bit more. Oop. Let's go with, let's do that one. adjust this out a little bit more. It'll make it look like it has some damaged paint towards the engine, where the air intake is, or where the exhaust is coming out, and we're gonna add a really cool effect to that as well. So, yeah, like I said, this is just a really rough coat, rough paint coat that we're putting down right now. And then once everything dries, then I'm gonna come back in with a final coat for everything. So don't panic. Okay, let's get a little bit more. Get a little bit more in the in my hopper. Okay. Okay, let's see here. Now this process may take us a couple of coats, just to have everything where we want it. You don't have to do it the way I am, but this is kind of how I'm getting it all set up for the rest of the paint job. Okay. Okay, now we're starting to have a little bit of trouble with the paint pooling. So let's go ahead and just kind of clean that off. Okay. All right, now we're gonna do back side of the tail. Okay, almost there. Okay, now. Switch that up one more section. Okay, a little bit more. Beautiful. Okay. All right, there we go. Let me just look over a couple more things and make sure that we're good. Nope. Okay, we missed a couple spots. All right, 1 second here while I adjust this. All right, that will do it. Okay. So we have the underbelly camouflage. And it's kind of hard to see in the video, but I'm letting some spots be darker than others. Reason for this is I want to give it the effect, again, of fading paint. Now, there's going to be certain areas on the aircraft that are going to be more worn than others. There's going to be sections that have like exhaust fumes going back behind it, where the guns fire. There could be a little bit of debris from the carbon from the gunpowder and such. So there's a few different things, different effects that we can do on that. But in the meantime, what we're going to do is this. So for now, I am going to let this dry overnight. The next video, part two of this. So this is going to be fuselage spraying part one. We're going to do part two more than likely tomorrow, since I have some time off over the weekend. We're going to do some final spraying and then we're going to continue building it. Okay. So that's the plan. Stay tuned. Thank you guys for your patience. I think we finally got the paint situation figured out. And I will have this marked off with paint with tape before we spray. Because that's going to take a long time and I just don't want to do a video with dead air. So that's the plan. Like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more and I will see everybody here in a little while.